I am Arjun. Okay, today's session we are going to solve problems on stress concentration in design of machine element 1. Okay, this is a given problem. A stepped shaft of circular cross section as shown in figure is made of 20 mm2 steel with yield stress 431.5 MPa. Determine the value of D diameter and fillet radius so that the maximum stress will be limited to a ratio of corresponding to a factor of safety of 2.5. So okay, so this is a given problem and this is a diagram. So now they have given a circular shaft of a stepped shaft of varying cross sections. The bigger cross section is 1.2D and the smaller cross section is D, and it has a fillet radius of 0.1D, and now it is subjected to a transverse load. We know that if a material is subjected to a transverse load, it will obviously induce bending in the particular member. So now this will be inducing bending in this particular member. Okay, so let us write down what are the parameters given. So they are given a transverse force F, which is equals to 30 kilonewton. So I will convert this into newton, 30 into 10 power 3 newton, and capital D is given. So this is capital D, which is 1.2 times D, and small d is given, it as D, so let us not worry about this. And radius, fillet radius, they are given it as 0.1 times D, and so at the end they are given factor safety, which is 2.5. okay, so from this particular diagram, whatever they are given, we can find out the ratio of D by D and R by D. So capital D by small d, so now capital D is 1.2D and small d is D, so this ratio happens to be 1.2. and let us find out similarly R by D ratio. R by D, so R is 0.1D and this D is D, so R by D happens to be 0.1. okay, so now with respect to this diagram they have given, okay, with respect to the diagram they have given, so we need to find out the value of K sigma, that is stress concentration factor. Okay, now if we go to figure 4.21a from the design data handbook. So now this is a design data handbook. So if we go to 4.21a, for R by D is equals to 0.1 and D by D is equals to 1.2, so this is R by D value of 0.1 and D by D is 1.2, so the value of 1.62, so approximately here you can see this, so it coincides to this point, this is 1.62. so now from figure 4.21a, from figure 4.21a design data handbook, so K sigma is 1.62, and we know that K sigma is equals to sigma maximum divided by sigma nominal. Okay, and since okay they are given yield stress, so we can find out maximum stress. So maximum stress is equals to yield stress divided by factor of safety. So yield stress is 431.5 MPa, so let us note that value here, 431.5 newton per mm square yield stress value is given, and factor of safety is given as 2.5, and this value will be 172.6 newton per mm square. Okay, and once we find out the value of maximum stress, and since we know the value of K sigma, we can easily find out sigma nominal, that is sigma nominal will be sigma maximum divided by K sigma. So now sigma nominal sigma maximum is 172.6 and K sigma is 1.62. now this value will be 106.54 newton per mm square. So since we got the value of sigma nominal, okay, now we got the value of sigma nominal. Okay, with this value, so So we have sigma nominal value here. Okay, now we know that for when transverse load is inducing bending, so we can find out nominal stress using bending equation. Sigma nominal is equals to mb by I into y r c. So we know that I is equals to pi d to the power of 4 divided by 64 for circular cross section, and this y is d by 2. So we know the value of nominal stress, which is 106.54. So let us substitute that value here. 106.54 is equals to, so mb is, okay, this if you look into the diagram, so now this is a diagram, this is a load acting, and this is least cross section, just 250 mm, 30 kilonewton into 250 mm is your mb, that is transverse load F into length of that particular section, which is 30 into 10 power 3 into L is 250 mm. Now this happens to be 77,500 into 10 power 3 newton mm. So let us substitute that value here. So we can directly take that value as 75 into 10 power 5 divided by I is pi d to the power of 4 divided by 64. Let us write as it is. D, y is d by 2, so we can cancel 1d and 1d, and I'll take this 64 to the numerator. So now 106.54 is equals to 75 10 power 5 into 64 divided by pi d cube. Okay, and we'll have this 2 in the denominator, so we'll keep it as it is. So with this, if you solve this equation, we are going to get the diameter as 89.50 mm, so approximately, so you can round off it to 90 mm, so diameter is 90 mm. And we know that radius is always diameter divided by 2, so 90 divided by 2 is, but fillet radius, okay, fillet radius is equals to 0.1 times d, that is 0.1 into 90 mm. So if you solve the value of fillet radius, if you find out the fillet radius happens to be 9 mm. Fillet radius happens to be 9 mm. Thank you.